So I'll tell you about one of those visits. This is a time when he was coming for his birthday celebration in December, Jayanti. So we had a beautiful puja in the morning at the house. We had an unbelievable, unforgettable evening of offerings at a public venue. It was called the Scottish Rite Auditorium. We were searching for venues all over the city. And when I would speak to the person, I would ask, what is the capacity? When I called that place, they said, the capacity is 770 people. I said, I'll come down and see you now and sign the contract. I knew instantly that was our place, and we used it many times afterwards because the address of the San Francisco IYI was 770 Dolores Street. So it seemed like some sort of divine synchronicity there. So we had this extraordinary program. It was packed. Someone had put together a slideshow. Think of this, a slideshow that was so magnificent and inspiring, celebrating Gurudev's life, celebrating integral yoga, that the end of the slideshow, the whole audience jumped to their feet in a standing ovation. I have never seen that before or since. So afterwards, we had arranged to go for an Indian dinner at Gaylord's restaurant in San Francisco. It was going to be a Lotus fundraising dinner. Many people had signed up. People came from all over California for Jayanti. Actually, they came from all over the country for this event. So we had a big dinner. People came up and greeted Gurudev afterwards, visited with him. It was going on to 2 a.m. when this finally ended, because after the evening event, it wasn't until about 11 o'clock that we began the meal. So we're leaving Gaylord's, there's an elevator to get down to the main level. Gurudev goes in, and then he starts beckoning different specific people to come into the elevator with him. You go, oh, this family, come on in. This family, come in. You come in. Hand picking. And I'm looking with my logical, analytical mind, and I notice the little sign, 12 people maximum occupancy. And I'm thinking, there are over 24 people in there now. And then he invited a few more, including me. And when we were shoulder to shoulder, like literally sardines, he pushed the button, the elevator started moving, and then with a lurch, stopped between floors. And I'm thinking, oh no, we overloaded it. It's 2 a.m. Who's going to be available to help us? Even in that shopping area, it was totally deserted, and you can't easily get a repair person at 2 in the morning on a Saturday night. So some people started making calls all over the city, and then some people stayed on the floor above us. Others went to the floor below us and started praying and chanting and Triambakam mantras, because you didn't know if all of a sudden it was going to drop and crash down. You had no idea what was going on. It began getting very hot and stuffy in there, to say the least. My immediate thought is we should all be as still as possible to conserve oxygen. And as if in response to my thought, Gurudev immediately said, let's all start chanting Rama, 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 Rama. Not only would we be using up a lot of oxygen, but if you know anything about the Rama chant, it's what's called a fire bija, a fire mantra. It increases heat. So I'm going, I don't know what's going on here. My logical mind was beginning to lose its footing in a way, and people started acting out in different ways. Some people were just trying to stay cool on all levels. Others began to panic. Some would jump up every few minutes and start pushing buttons. One person actually got on someone's shoulders and tried to crawl out the top of the compartment. And I'm thinking, he must know what he's doing. I'm sure he's in charge. But still, the mind was thinking, what's going on here? And how is this finally going to play out? So we were in that compartment, as I recall, maybe 40, 45 minutes. And then Gurudev simply leaned over, pushed a button, the elevator started, and we were at ground level, and everyone dispersed. I happened to be in the car with him as we were returning to the institute. And we asked him, Gurudev, what was going on in there? We're stuck. People keep pushing the buttons. There's no response. It doesn't look like there's going to be an easy solution here. And then all of a sudden, you press a button and it moves again. And Gurudev's reply was, well, it's really very simple. God wanted to make a test. When all the data was in and he had all the information he needed, there was not a need for the test to continue even another second. So it was over. My lesson from that is, two lessons actually. There's a higher plan behind everything that unfolds in our life. Everything that unfolds in the lives of our loved ones, everything that unfolds in the world. And secondly, with respect to karma, as soon as a karma has been purged, instantly everything can turn around. But a beautiful ending to that story is